A relation is nothing but it is a subset of the Cartesian product. X minus y is a multiple of 3 means you have to find that it is an equivalence relation. Every element of relation present in Cartesian product. Therefore, relation is a subset of the Cartesian product, which is divisible by one and only itself. It is going to be known as a prime number. Hello dear students, a warm welcome to one and all. My name is Vibha, mathematics faculty at Vidyashram Pre-University College, the Temple of Excellence, Mysuru. So in the last session, we have learned about how to solve the problems on what? Cartesian product, isn't it? Now in this session of the chapter number 2, sets, relations and functions, session number 6, we are going to learn the topics of what? The meaning of the Cartesian product. And then definition of the relation, types of the relation, and then problems we are going to have it as based on those. Okay. Now, what do you mean by that? Is nothing but Cartesian product. What is a Cartesian product? Cartesian product is nothing but set of all possible ordered pairs. Ordered pairs is nothing but Cartesian product. Cartesian product between A and B, correct? Ordered pairs between A and B is nothing but the Cartesian product, and it is denoted by what? A cross B. Number of elements of A into number of elements of B, you are going to write that many ordered pairs. Got that is going to be known as the Cartesian product. Now, what do you mean by the relation? A relation is nothing but it is a subset of the Cartesian product. So let me take the example to explain you what you mean by a relation, especially here. So here I am going to take it as letter. Set A will be having the elements of 1, 2 and 3. Okay, set B is having the elements of 1, 4 and then 9 and then 16. Let me take this is a set A elements and then set B element. What is a set A cross B are going to have? A cross B is nothing but all the ordered pairs of number of A and number of B, correct? Cross number of B. So which you are going, number of A elements are 3 cross, number of B elements are 4, you are going to have it as which will be is equal to 12 ordered pairs you are going to have in A cross B. Let me write down here A cross B. A cross B is nothing but 1, 1. See, 1, 1. Correct? Like this. 1, 4, 1, 9. Okay? Comma. And then you are going to have it as 1, 16. 1, 16. Similarly, it will go along with the 2. 2, 1, 2, 4, you can observe here 2, 9 and then 2, 16. Correct? Similarly, it will go with the 3. That is 3, 1, 3, 4, 3, 9, 3, 16. Isn't it? These are all the ordered pairs you are going to have. 16 you can count. 4, 4, 8, 8, 4, 6. You are going to have it. Sorry, 12. 12 ordered pairs you should have here. You are having 12 ordered pairs accordingly. What I am going to do here, I am going to take a small change here. I am going to give a relation. Relation means connectivity. Here there is no connectivity. Simply you are writing all possible ordered pairs, isn't it? What I am going to do now, I am going to give some connection. Connection is nothing but some relation. Relation between X and Y I am going to form. Okay. So what is a relation I am going to make it as? Here I am going to make a relation as connectivity between X is a square root of y. Okay, this is a connectivity especially I am giving. You can observe 1 is a square root of 1, correct? 2 is a square root of 1 is a square root of 4, no, square root of 4 never equal to 1. 1 is a square root of 9, never equal to 1. 1 is a square root of 16, no. Square root of 16 is equal to what? 4. Square root of 9 is 3. Square root of 4 is 2. Correct? So therefore, here you can observe only 1 is a square root of 1 itself. So this is the element is connected. So according to this relation, I am going to write the ordered pairs. 1 is only the square root of 1. Okay, similarly, these are all the x element dears. These are all the x element. These are all the y elements. Okay, 1, 4, 9, 16 are the y element. 1, 2, 3 are the x element. Got? So, x is the square root of y. And 2 is the square root of 1? No. Square root of 1 is 1 only. 4 is the square root of 2? Yes. 4 is the square root of 2 means 2 is the square root of 4. So, therefore, you are going to write it as 2, 4 is another ordered pair. Are you getting? Next, what is 3 is a square root of, 2 is not a square root of 9, 2 is not a square root of 16. We are not going to write that ordered pair. Why? Because I am given a connectivity between x and y. This connection which holds good only, I should write the ordered pair. Are you getting? So 3 is a square root of 1? No. 3 is a square root of 4? No. 3 is a square root of 9? Yes. 3 is a square root of 9. So we are going to make a connection here. 3 is a square root of 9. That's it. Okay, along with the comma, again, no elements are left out here. Yes, no elements are left out. All the elements are being there here. The ordered pair according to the given relation. Now, you need to check, dear students, is these ordered pairs are present in A cross B? Yes, 1, 1. 1, 1 is here. 2, 4. 2, 4 is here. 3, 9. 3, 9 is here. You can check over. Therefore, these ordered pairs are present in the Cartesian product. Therefore, this relation is said to be the subset of the Cartesian product. Because every element of relation present in Cartesian product. Therefore, relation is a subset of the Cartesian product. I hope you understood by this example. Understood? So, we are going to now the definition of the relation by this example. What do you mean by a relation? Relation means let A and B be two non-empty set you are going to have. Non-empty set, not the empty set. A relation R from A to B is a subset of A cross B. As already told you, this is a subset of A cross B by that example. Therefore, we are going to say that R is a relation from A to B. R is a relation from A to B because I am giving a connection from X to Y here. The elements of set A is called as X. The element of set B is going to be known as Y. Okay, here. Next, we'll be moving on to how we are going to denote. We are going to denote R is a subset of A cross B. So, what is the notification we can have here? See, a relation R from A to A is a subset of A cross A. Suppose A to A only they have asked you to calculate. Therefore, R is said to be a relation from A to A is nothing but A cross A is a subset. Okay. Next, if set A as M number of elements and set B as N number of elements, then AB has MN elements. Okay, how many elements do you have in A? Here you can calculate A as 3 elements, B as 4 elements, then the relation will be having MN elements. That is, MN elements means you are going to have according to the connectivity. So therefore here A cross B has 2 power MN subsets. They are going to ask you like this only. They will be given a set A and set B. How many subsets do you have in that relation? In that relation, A cross B has what subset? How many subsets do you have in A cross B? Do you have in A cross B means 2 power MN subsets you are having in A cross B. Suppose if they're given like this, N of A is equal to 3 elements. N of B is equal to 2 elements. What is subset? Subsets of A cross B. See? Subsets of A cross B is nothing but 2 power MN, which is nothing but 2 power, M is nothing but this, N is nothing but this. So 2 power 3 into 2, which is nothing but 2 power 6. If you write, this is all the subsets of the Cartesian product. That is a notification. Next, if there exists 2 power MN relations from A to B, then there are 2 power MN relations from B to A. How many number of relations? Number of relations is equal to the number of subsets. Dears, carefully observe this. Number of subsets is equal to the number of relations. Number of relations also same thing, 2 power mn only you are going to have it as. So A to B, how many relations you are going to have? B to A also same number of relations you are going to have it as. That note you have to confirm. And again, if R is a relation from A to B and xy belongs to R, then this is denoted by x related to y. How we are going to write? If A comma B, A comma B belongs to R, means we are going to write this one as A is related to B. Okay, A is related to B means A is having a relation in B. That's it. A is having a connection in B. Some connection we are giving. How I have given a x is a square root of y, you can give it as A is a square root of B. That means set A elements are A and then B elements are B, small letter B, you are going to name it as. Understood? Yes, we'll be moving on to the next, domain and the range. This is very, very important. What do you mean by a domain and what do you mean by a range? Here, domain is nothing but in the relation, what are all the first element are going to be known as the domain. What are all the second elements are going to be known as the range. For example, here I have taken, see here, this is ordered by, after making a relation. This is after making a relation. Relation always represented by the letter R. Are you getting? So here the set of all first element, this is 1, 2 and 3. These are all going to be known as the domain of the element. And the second element, that is 1, 4 and then 9. These second element of the ordered pair in a relation is going to be known as the range that you have to notify. Okay. So that's what I am explained here. Let A and B two non-empty sets. R be a relation from A to B. Then that is R contained in A cross B. The domain of R is defined as the collection of all the first elements of the ordered pairs. That means this A, okay? This is going to be known as the in the ordered pair of a relation. First element is the domain. Second element is always the range. That you have to remember. Okay, here domain of R is nothing but A belongs to A. That's what this one. A belongs to A, where A comma B belongs to R. Here this element, first element, A belongs to A. A belongs to A means for the first element, first set. B belongs to the second set. Here the range R is defined as a set of all second element in the ordered pair. We are going to define it as B belongs to R, where A comma B belongs to relation. How I have given the first example, the first element are going to be known as the domain, second element of the ordered pair in a relation is going to be known as the range. That you have to remember. That's it. Okay, next we'll be moving on to the inverse relation. What do you mean by inverse? Inverse means ulta. What you are writing the ordered pairs in a relation, ulta if you write it as, it is a inverse. That's what, see, let R be a relation from A to B, then inverse relation, it is denoted by R inverse. R inverse, this is not the minus one, inverse symbol, okay? Inverse symbol. R inverse, it is a relation from B to A, ulta, A to B, B to A. So here subset of B cross A defined as follows. That is what you are going to have it as. R inverse is y comma x for all x comma y belongs to R. What is that? X comma y belongs to R means y comma x belongs to R inverse. Relation is x comma y. R inverse is inverse relation is y comma x. That's it they have given here. For example, you can have here, let A is equal to 1, 2 and B is equal to A comma B. Now I am going to write R is a relation from A to B is defined as what? 1 comma A, 1 comma B, like this. And then 2 comma A, 2 comma B, correct? So that we have given here, that is a relation R. Be careful, relation R, I am giving a connection here. What is R inverse? R inverse means ulta. A will come first, 1 will go next. B will come first, 1 will go next. A will come first, 2 will go next. That's it. See, you are going to have it as. So here I have not defined like that. Here they have given a connection. Relation they have given like this. This is the Cartesian product what I told. This is a relation they have defined. So here A comma 1, B comma 1, A comma 2. Ulta you are going to write it as inverse relation. That's it. That you have to remember. Next, types of relation. What do you mean by identity relation? Here identity relation is nothing but IA we are going to denote it by. Let A be the non-empty set. then IA is defined as A comma A. The same you are going to have. Same identification, okay? Like a twins. So that is going to be known as the identity relation A comma A for all A belongs to A is called the identity relation on A. What do you mean by a null relation? Null relation are going to be known as a void relation. We are going to name that one. Here I have written. So let A be a non-empty set. We know that. 5 means what? It is an empty set. Empty means the null set. Null set is contained in A cross A and hence 5 is a relation on A. And this relation is going to be known as the null relation. If the empty set is present in A cross A, we are going to name that one as the a null relation. Okay. Next, universal relation. What do you mean by universal? If A cross A is contained in A cross A, then we are going to name it as it is a universal relation. Okay. Hence, A into A, that is AA, is a relation on A. This relation is called universal relation on A. A cross A contained in A cross A. All the elements of A, set A should be present in all the elements of set A cross A. Then, that is A cross B will be contained in A cross B itself. It is going to be known as the universal relation. Understood? Next, we'll be moving on to the reflexive relation. This is very important. A reflexive relation is nothing but a relation R on a non-empty set. A is called the reflexive as identity. If A comma A belongs to relation A. Okay? Here, if A is equal to ABC, then R1, A comma A, B comma B. See? A comma A, B comma B. R2, A comma A, B comma B, C comma C. C comma C. These are going to be known as the reflection relation. Same. You should see the set A comma A, B comma B. Should not A comma B. A comma A, B comma B, C comma C. Okay. That is going to be known as the reflexive. And then you are going to have the identity relation and the universal relation on a non-empty set are going to be known as the reflexive relation. What do you mean by identity relation? A comma A belongs to A. This is called identity relation. What is a reflexive? This is a reflexive. Same na? Both are going to be known as what? Reflexive relations on the relations of the given. That is identity relation and the reflexive relations, right? Universal relation. Now, what do you mean by the symmetric? Symmetric relation means a relation R on a non-empty set A is called symmetric. If A comma B belongs to R, implies that B comma A is also there in R. 1 comma 2 belongs to R, implies that 2 comma 1 is also there in R. Okay? That is also there in R. It is going to be known as the symmetric relation. Next, transitive. That is, relation R on a non-empty set A is called transitive. If A comma B belongs to R, B comma C belongs to R, then implies A comma C belongs to R. Suppose if you are having, if A is equal to 1, 2, 3, suppose R is a relation, you are going to have it as 1 comma 1, 1 comma 2. 2 comma 3 and then 1 comma 3 like this. You can observe here, this is A comma B, this is B comma C, this is A comma C, correct? So therefore, if A comma B is there in R, B comma C is also there in R, then A comma C must be there in R. Then only it is going to be say as transitive relation. That is what the transitive relation says. Then what do you mean by equivalence? Equivalence relation means the relation must be reflexive, relation must be symmetric, relation must holds good for transitive. If all the three relations are holds good, then it is said to be a equivalence relation. Definition goes like this. If a relation R on a non-empty set A is called the equivalence, if it is reflexive, symmetric and then transitive. This definitions, they are going to ask it for a one marker in your examinations. Okay. Equivalence relation is nothing but this. What do you mean by antisymmetric? Antisymmetric is nothing but a relation R on a non-empty set A is called an antisymmetric relation. If A comma B, B comma A, both are there in R, then we are going to say that A will be is equal to B. Okay, that is going to be known as the antisymmetric. Symmetric is A comma B belongs to R, then B comma A also there in R. A comma B, B comma A both are present, then if A equal to B, first element is equal to the second element, then we are going to say that it is an antisymmetric. Got? Okay, based on the formula what we have learned now, what are all the number of relations, how you are going to calculate? 2 power mn. Number of subsets, 2 power mn you are going to calculate, isn't it? And the relation is nothing but it is a subset of A cross B. So based on that, let us look into the problems of the one marker and also the two marker problems here. What they have given the question, dears? Here they have given S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. State which of the following is a relation on S. So what they have given the relation, let me check out. R is equal to 1, 2, 2, 0 and then 3, 1. Let me write it here. This is a set A and set B. So set A will be containing the first elements of the ordered pairs 1, 2 and 3, and set B is containing the second elements of the ordered pairs, that is nothing but 2, 0, 1. Obviously, you are having dears. Here 1 is getting connected to 2, correct? And then 2 is getting connected to 0 and then 3 is getting connected to 1. But I am asking you, 0 is an element of S? No. Element of S are nothing but only 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore, this is not a relation on S. Not a relation on S, because in the set B, you do not have 0 as the element, which is not an element of a S given. That's it. Okay, let us look into the second one. 1, 3, 4, 2, 2, 4 and 1, 4. Dear students, if two ordered pairs have same as first element, then it is not a relation. See here? If two ordered. So what you are going to have it as? Let me look at, not like that. So here, dear students, let me look into the problem and then solve like this. I am going to write the ordered pair as like this. See, you are having 1, a 4. See, 1, 4 and then 2, 1. So repeated elements are writing only one time. So 1, 4, 2 and then 1, correct? So 1, 4, 2 you are going to have it as, but you should have 1, 2, 3, 4. Here 4 is missing, here 4 you are having, isn't it? So what I am going to write it as here, 4 is missing, even though you are having all the element, but 4 is here, 3 is missing. Here 3 is missing, here 4 is missing. That also you can identify. 1, 2, 3, 4 means all the elements should be getting connected. Yes, all the elements must be getting connected. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 is missing. Here is 3 is missing. So therefore, this is not a relation. Therefore, I can write it as 3, 2, 4, 1. So 3, 2, 4 you are going to have. 1 is getting connected to 3 and then 4 is getting connected to 2 and then 2 is getting connected to 4. But you do not have 3 as an element here. Therefore, 3 is missing over there. So this is not a relation. Not a relation on S. Are you getting? On yes, you must have all the elements must be present in the domain set. All the elements must be here also. All the elements must be present in the domain set. Whatever the codomain, I'm not going to worry. I'm worrying about the domain set here. Are you getting? So next we'll be moving on to the one marker again. If A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, find the following relations from A to B. Let me look in what they have given. X comma y where x is greater than y. You should choose the number where x is greater than y. Let me calculate now. 1 is greater than 1? No. 1 equal to 1. 1 is greater than 2? No. 1 is greater than 3? No. 1 is greater than 4? No. 1 is greater than 5? No. Therefore, 2 is greater than 1? Yes. So 2 is greater than 1. Therefore, R1, you can write it as 2 is greater than 1, 2 comma 1, x comma y, x is greater than y. Next, 2 is greater than 3, no, you cannot write that ordered pair. 2 is greater than 4, no, 2 is greater than 5, no. So let me calculate again from 3, 3 is greater than 1, yes, 3 is greater than 1, therefore 3 is greater than 1, 3 comma 1, right? This is x element, this is y element, x comma y, x is greater than y. Are you getting? Next, you are going to have 3 is greater than 2. Yes, 3 is greater than 2. Let me calculate here. 3 is greater than 2. Correct. Next, you are going to have 3 is greater than 4. No, you cannot write that order pair. 3 is greater than 5. No. Next, 4 is greater than 1. Yes. So 4 is greater than 1. Again, 4 is greater than 2. 4 is greater than 2. Each element you are going to relate it here. Each element with the other element. Okay. Next, 4 is greater than 3. Yes. 4 is greater than 3. Next, you are going to have 4 is greater than 5. No, 4 is never greater than 5. Let me look into the 5. 5 is greater than 1, 5 is greater than 2, 5 is greater than 3, 5 is greater than 4. All the elements will come. 5 is greater than 1, 5 is greater than 2, comma, 5 is greater than 3, 5 is greater than 4. 5 is never greater than 5. It is equal to 5. This is a relation for the given equation. Are you getting this? Each element you take with the other element, you are going to relate what they have given the relation. Got? You are going to write ordered pair x, y only. You should relate this relation. That's it. Okay? You should give that connectivity. Got? Yes. We'll look on to the next problem. If A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, find the following relations from A to B. What they have given? X, y, where x divides y. X divides y means what? X will be, y will be dividing by x. That's it. X divides y. You are going to have it as. So therefore, 1 divides 1. Yes. 1 divides 1. Therefore, R2 is equal to 1 will be divisible by 1. X divides y. Correct? So that is 1 will be divisible by 1. Next, you are going to have it as, again, 1 will be divisible by 2. No. Again, 1 will be divisible by 3. No. 1 divides 4. No. 1 divides 4. No. Not divisible. Divides. 1 divides 2. You are going to have it as yes. 1 divides 2. That is 2 is divisible by 1. That's it. 2 is divisible by 1. Are you getting? Next, you are going to have it as, see, again, 1 divide, 3 is divisible by 1. Yes, 3 is divisible by 1. Compare 1 by 1, yes. 1 is divisible by 1, yes. Again, 1 is divisible by 2, no. 1 is divisible by 3, 1 is divisible by 4, 1 by 4, 1 by 5, never. It should give integer, isn't it? Next, you are going to have 2 is divisible by 1, yes. 2 is divisible by 2, yes. So, 2 is divisible by 2. Again, you are going to have it as 2 is divisible by 3? No. 2 by 4? No. 2 by 5? No. 2 by 5, again a fraction. Next, you are going to have it as 3 is divisible by 1? Yes. So, you are going to have 3 is divisible by 1. Correct? Next, you are going to have it as 3 is divisible by 2? No. 3 by 2 is a fraction. 3 is divisible by 3? Yes. 3 comma 3. Again, 3 by 4, no. 3 by 5, no. So, next you are going to have it as 4 by 1. Correct. 4 by 1 is 4. So, 1 comma 4, only integer you should get yours. 4 by 1 is 4. Again, you are going to have 4 by 2. Correct. 4 by 2 is 2. So, it will be divisible 4 by 2. 4 by 2. So, 2 comma 4. 4 by 2. Y by X. Next, you are going to have it as 4 by 4. Yes, 4 by 4. So, 4 by 4. Next, you are going to have it as 4 by 5. No. So, again, 5 is divisible by 1. Yes. So, therefore, 5, 1. Again, 5 by 2, 5 by 3, 5 by 4, 5 by 5. 5 by 5 can be. So, these are all the ordered pairs of X divides Y, or Y is divisible by X. Y divisible by X. Okay, that's it. We'll move on to the next problem. If A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, find the following relations from A to B. What they have given? X, y, y is equal to x plus 3. So, I need to take the x value from the given set. Let me take the x value. As x is equals to 1, what is y is equal to? Y will be is equals to x plus 3. Correct? They have given the relation, which will become 1 plus 3, which will become 4. Again, x is equals to 2. I should take the values from the given set only. X is equal to 2 means you are going to have it as y is equal to 2 plus 3, which will be giving you 5. Next, therefore, the ordered pairs are x, y. What is the x value? 1. What is the y value I got? 4. This is x, y. Next, what is the x value I have given? 2. What is the y value I got? 5. X, y. Next, if I give it as x is equal to 3, what I am getting? Y is equal to 2 plus 3 plus 3. What is 3 plus 3 you are getting? 6. But is it 6 in the set? Yes. No. 6 does not belong to yes. Therefore, this cannot be a relation. From the ordered pair of 3, 4, 5, if I give 4, I'll be getting yes. 4 plus 3, 7. 7 does not belong to the set. If I give 5, I'll get 5 plus 3 is nothing but 8. 8 does not belong to the set. Therefore, you are going to write it as R3 will be having only two ordered pair, which is nothing but 1 comma 4 and then 2 comma 5. That's it. This is R3 relation. Are you getting this? Yes. Okay, we'll move on to the next question. What they have given? If A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, find the following relations from it. X equal to Y. When it equal, 1 equal to 1, is 1 equal to 2? Never. So therefore, you are going to have it as 1 will be is equal to 1, 1 never equal to 2, 1 never equal to 3, 1 never equal to 4, 1 never equal to 5. Similarly, 2 equal to 2 never equal to 1, 2 equal to 2. So you are going to have 2 equal to 2. Similarly, 3 equal to 3. Similarly, 4 equal to 4. And then 5 equal to 5. Why? Until 5, I am not checking 6 because you are having only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as elements of set yes there. Are you getting this? So this is a relation for the given equation. Got yes or the given relation. Yes. We'll move on to the next question. A relation or in a collection of a set of integers defined by x, y. X minus y is a multiple of 3. X minus y is a multiple of 3 means you have to find that it is an equivalence relation. See, you are going to have it as your reflexive relation, symmetric relation, and then transitive relation. Let me look into this problem. What is that? R is equal to x, y. X minus y is a multiple of a 3. Show that R is an equivalence relation on Z. Z means what? Set of integers. Suppose, yes, I am going to take it as reflexive. What is a reflexive? Reflexive relation says that if A belongs to A, A comma A belongs to the relation, must belongs to the relation. That is called reflexive relation. Now, if I am going to take it as 1 minus 1, what is 1 minus 1? Which is nothing but the 0. 0 is a multiple of 3? No. So, you are going to have it 3 into 0 is 0. You can have it as that. So, 3 minus 3, if I take it as any number which is nothing but the multiple of 3, so that I have to choose the x comma y such like. Okay. So, multiple of 3 means you are going to have x minus y will belongs to obviously if x is a multiple of 3, y is a multiple of 3, then you are going to have it as x minus y is also a multiple of 3. Okay. So, therefore, you can write it as here x comma y since x minus x is equal to 0 is a multiple of 3, because 0 into 0, 3 will gives you 0 only. So 0 into 3, 0 into anything will be 0 only, but here I am taking particularly 3 because they have given it as multiple of 3. So therefore R is reflexive. Okay, and then asymmetric. What is symmetric? You are going to have it as symmetric means, see, if x minus y is multiple of 3 implies that minus of x minus y or y minus x, correct na? See, it implies that y minus x also multiple of 3. For example, multiple of 3. For example, if you are going to take it as 3 minus 6, what is 3 minus 6? Minus 3. What is 6 minus 3? 3. Minus 3 is also multiple of 3. 3 is also multiple of 3. Correct? So therefore, x minus y is a multiple of 3 implies that y minus x also multiple of 3. Therefore, y comma x belongs to R. Correct? Y comma x belongs to R means the relation is a symmetric. Similarly, you are going to have a transitive relation. What do you mean by transitive? If x minus y is multiple of 3, okay, and y minus z is multiple of 3, then adding these two, x minus y plus y minus z, what it will give? Plus y minus y will get cancelled, implies that x minus z is also multiple of 3. That's it. Therefore, x comma z belongs to the relation R. x comma z belongs to the relation R. Therefore, it is said to be a transitive. It is reflexive. It is symmetric. It is transitive. Therefore, the given relation is a equivalence relation. That's it, dears. Okay, we'll move on to the next question. 2-mark question. What they are given? If A is equal to 2, 3, B is equal to 3, 4, find the number of relations that can be defined from A to B. What is the number of relations formula? Number of relations is given by number of relations is given by is equal to 2 power mn. What is the m number? That is m is equal to n of a. N of a is how much you are going to have it as 2. And n is equal to n of b. Number of elements in b is nothing but 2. So what you are going to have? 2 power 2 into 2. Which you are going to get the answer is 2 power 4. Which is nothing but 16. Number of relations you can form here from A to B. That's it. One marker or two marker. Writing the formula is one marker. Getting the answer is one marker, two marker. Got? Yes. We'll move on to the next question. If R is equal to 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, 1, 7. Find the domain and the range. What is the domain? Set of all. First element of the ordered pair is a domain. Set of all. Second element of the ordered pair is a range. First element is nothing but what? This one. These are all the first element. But repeated elements are writing only one time. Correct? Repeated elements is written as only one time. So therefore you are going to have it as domain. Domain is nothing but you are going to have only one element, that is 1, which I have tick marked. And then range is nothing but see 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That is the range. So second element. Range is nothing but you are going to have it as 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 7. Okay. So if you want to write the cross product, you can write here. R is a relation. 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, 1, 7. That's it. Relation. Understood? So first element is a domain. Second element of ordered pair is a range. Repeated elements are writing only one time. Got? Yes. Next, we'll be moving on to the find the domain and the range of the following such that R is equal to x, y, y is equal to x cube, where x is a positive prime lesser than 10. Which are all the positive prime lesser than 10? Positive prime, lesser than 10. What are all those? 2 is a prime number. 3 is a prime number, 5 is a prime number, 7 is a prime number. Is any other prime number? No. Only that many prime numbers you are going to 2, 3, 5 and 7. 9 and then 10 is nothing but they are all the composite number. Correct? Prime number means what? Which is divisible by 1 and only itself. It is going to be known as a prime number. So therefore that cube you are going to have. This is the x value you are going to take. These are all the x values. Okay? X values you are going to take it as. Therefore y is equal to x cube means you are going to have it as x is equal to what is that? Y is equal to x cube. You are going to take the values as 2 cube is nothing but what? You are going to have 2 cube is 8, isn't it? So like that you are going to form. So r will be is equal to. So therefore r will be is equal to, if I am going to take the value as 2, x is a positive integer, you are going to have it as. So therefore you are going to get the relation as will be is equal to. Relation you can get like this. 2 comma, what is that? X value will be 2 and y value will be what? X cube. If x is equal to 2, y will be is equal to x cube. What is x cube? 2 cube. What is 2 cube? 8. Similarly, if x is equal to 3, y will be is equal to 3 cube. What is that 3 cube? 27. Correct? Like that you are going to have. Therefore, the answer you are going to get it as r is equal to 2 comma 2 cube is 8 and 3 comma 3 cube is 27. Similarly, 5 cube is nothing but 125. So similarly, you are going to have it as 7 cube. 7 cube is nothing but 343. 7, 343. Correct? 7, 343 you are going to have it as. So you are going to have 2 cube is 8, 3 cube is 27, 5 cube is 125, 7 cube is 343. So therefore domain is nothing but what? Set of all first element. Domain is nothing but 2, 3, 5, 7. Range is nothing but what? Range is nothing but set of all second element. What are all the second element? These are all the second element. So that is 8, 27, 125, 343. That are all the second element you are going to have it as. Understood? This is how you are going to have dominate the range. Next, if R inverse is equal to 2, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 3, 2, find R. If R inverse, R means ulta of that one. That's it. What is R? R you are going to write it as 4, 2 and then 1, 2 is there, 2, 1 and then 3, 1 is there, 1, 3 and then 3, 2 is there, 2, 3. That is what R. R inverse ulta you are going to get it. That's it. Easy. Yes. Next you are going to have it as three marker list. All the relations on the set A is equal to A comma B. All the relations means you are going to have it as 2 power mn relations. Correct. A to A you are going to have it as 2 power mn means 2 power 2 into 2. Which will be is equal to 2 power 4, which will be is equal to 16. So therefore, all the relations means you are going to have A comma A comma B like that. To try to cover this one, how we are going to write it as all the elements of that one. Okay. 2 power 4 is nothing but 16 elements you are going to have it as. Next you are going to have, if A is equal to 4, 5, 6, 7, R1 is equal to 4, 4, 5, 6, 6, 7, 7. Represent R1 by Venn diagram. So how we are going to write? You are going to write the set of all elements as A, and then this is a B. So this is a set A, this is a set B, and the relation we are going to do R, set A elements as 4, 5, 6, 7. So 4, 5, 6, 7. Next set B element 4, 6, 7, 7. So 4, 6, 7. Okay. Repeated elements are written only one time. Now they have connected 4 to 4, 4 to 4 connection, and then 5 to 6, 5 to 6, and then you are going to have 6 to 7, 6 to 7, and then you are going to have 7 to 7. 7 to 7. This is how you are going to have the diagrammatic representation. That's it, dears. Is that easier, dears? Yes. Okay. So I hope you understood this session, how we are going to solve the problems based on the given questions. So thank you, dear students. In the next session, we'll be moving on to the functions. Thank you.